of Joshua Pacio. Pacio, the former world champion. Saruta, the one world champion and Shooto world champion. Fake there from Saruta. Switching stance between Wilcox and Southpaw here.
That's the low leg kicks of Joshua Pacio. He says he wants to attack that lower part of the leg and start kicking the calf of Saruta.
Now Mitch, Saruta isn't using that awkward, strange 90 degree angled guard we saw him use last time. Oh, throwing it back kick! Smack bang in the guts from Joshua Pacio.
Nice spinning back kick from Joshua Pacio. You're right, Michael, he's not utilizing that guard, but again, that's more of the mind games coming from the ninja. Doesn't want to utilize that guard, but I do think we'll see it later on in this matchup.
Overhand right from Saruta, outside leg kick, overhand right again there from Saruta. Chance went up for Let's Go Pacio here in Manila.
Nice duck under to a double leg from Saruta as he ends up in half guard.
Pacio receiving instruction from Mark Sanjao in the corner here from Team Legai. Half guard position for the champion. To posture up and work that vicious ground and pound that he had. Patience here from Pacio, a stalemate move.
You can see Saruta's got his head wrapped around, or his arm, his left arm wrapped around the neck there. He can try to get past his half guard position of Joshua Pacio. There's a choke he's got as long as Joshua Pacio holds the head in that position.
Work for finish.
Under 3 minutes remaining, first round set for five for the strawweight world title. Referee Kim Chung right on top of the action. If Pacio can win the title back, the Mall of Asia Arena will melt down. To their feet, inside leg kick here from the champion Saruta. Oh, the high kick! Tried for the headache maker, did Joshua Pacio.
Joshua Pacio's going head hunting early. He's already tried to go upstairs a couple of times now.
Big hello to all our fans watching on ABS-CBN Sports in Action here in the Philippines, on Abima TV in Japan. Skips forward the champion, doesn't commit though. There's a left hand from Saruta. Looking inside the Mall of Asia Arena when they chant Pacio's name. All of Team Legai's former champions are here. Flying Bellignon, Eustaquio. Also in attendance, circle side, the world's heavyweight champion, Philippine star Brandon Vera. So many luminaries have turned out in force for this night of nights in Filipino martial arts. The balls of his feet again here, Saruta. Inside leg kick from the champion. Still, Mitch, a filling out process from both of these two competitors.
You know, they're still kind of just, you know, there's not a lot of...
Oh, big right back! The big kibosh from Saruta. And Pacio on the canvas, on his back now.
That's the end of the filling out process, I assume.
Saruta's got some confidence flowing now. He tries to mount it.
Pacio's got to keep tight to get his grip back. This is where Saruta's got to create a little bit of space. I'd like to see him frame off the head and start pushing the head down. There he goes. Good scramble by Joshua.
Pacio back to his feet. The crowd appreciates that. Let's see the Russian style is now with Pacio. And he beat the champion to the strikes.
Well, the first match happened about 13 weeks ago, so that's not a lot of time to make a lot of improvement. But what you can do is you can get in better shape and also figure out your game plan. Whoever can implement their game plan to perfection tonight is going to be the one who walks away with that belt.
Moving punches from Pacio. 20 seconds remains. Low check there from Saruta. And Saruta taunting in the mind games from the Japanese world champion.
Taunting with the right hand there. Is that what he's doing?
Trying to get inside the head of Pacio. Pacio jumping roundhouse kick off the lead leg. Be a Filipino victory. Good two-punch combination off the bell there for Pacio. Switching stance, Saruta. Keiji veteran. has all the tricks in the book, and then some that aren't even written in the book. Pacio looks to get airborne with that knee, but didn't commit to it, didn't have the distancing.
Action!
Saruta inside leg kick. High kick from Pacio. He's enjoying that high right roundhouse tonight. Hasn't really found success with it, though.
He was expecting to throw that roundhouse kick off of the awkward guard shown by Saruta, and Saruta hasn't shown him that guard yet. Again, more of that veteran mind game move as Pacio.
Spinning back fist from Saruta.
Okay.
Counter punch from Pacio. Accidentally
struck
the back of the head. Apologies there. Good sportsmanship. The media attention on this bout, on this entire card, has been crazy. Our media conference at City of Dreams earlier on in the week was a record attendance, some 500 plus media members. The biggest in history. All over the news and Team Lakai. Athletes appearing on CNN Philippines earlier this week. Outside leg kick there from Saruta. Manila really is a hotbed for one championship. Indeed, this entire combat crazy nation love one championship, especially when it comes to town. It was in Saruta's town a couple of weeks ago in Tokyo. And Falayang saw the title lost against Shinya Aoki, who put him to sleep in the first round. Meaning that all of Team Lakai's titles were gone. It's now the responsibility of Pacio to win one back for the men from Baguio City.
Good movement shown by Saruta, but as soon as Saruta stopped and got a stationary stance, that's when Pacio spun and landed another spinning back kick. I think this movement's kind of got Joshua Pacio a little bit confused here in the second as he marches forward and throws a big right hand there from Saruta.
Haven't really seen Pacio open up with his wushu, with the striking, the combinations. Has had some acrobatics, turning back kicks and jumping roundhouse kicks. Nothing that's landed effective telling blows absolutely so far. Another agonizingly close rear leg roundhouse kick. Left-hand followed by a right there by Saruta.
Saruta closes that distance incredibly fast with that lightning fast footwork, how he's in and out of there. And Pacio seems to have a hard time getting into the rhythm.
Lots of angles being cut here from Saruta.
Like that strategy employed by Saruta, not to stay still as he ducks under a big head kick there.
Certainly, Pacio is going for that head kick time and time again. And there's the first show of that strange forearm guard that Saruta did last time that confounded Pacio. Oh, overhand right from Saruta, tried for the counter.
Pacio said he didn't want to spin as much as he did in the first time, because you can start to see that Saruta started to time that, started to step to the outside right as Pacio was spinning. And that's the same mistake that Foliang made with Nguyen. Nguyen saw it coming over and over again, and he started to step to the side. And then what happened? Boom, a big overhand right that caught Foliang mid-spin. Pacio's got to be careful with this spinning.
Inside leg kick there from Saruta. Mitch went high on the thigh, but do you think that both men are holding back a little here? We haven't really seen them put the foot down to the gas.
Well, in the second round, they're still trying to get a bearing on each other. So I don't think Pacio expected Saruta to A, come out in this stance, be this mobile, and I think Saruta is a little bit surprised at the inactivity coming back from Pacio, because Pacio said he did not want to wait, he did not want to hesitate. Last 10 seconds.
Another break off there from Saruta. Final few seconds of this round. High kick from Pacio. Roundhouse kick from Pacio, just tucked under the left arm. Thrust out the jab as the Filipino. Body shot, stuck it well, belly button through the back.
Pacio likes that technique. He likes to go high with the roundhouse and then follow it up with a spinning back kick. He was able to drop Roy Deliguez back in 2017 in the second round with a beautiful spinning back fist off of that roundhouse kick.
Let's see if Pacio can work those wushu kicking skills of his. Lots of movement here from Yosuke Saruta. Saruta, the current world champion, Pacio, the former world champion. And right there from Pacio.
Saruta is still the owner of the biggest punch to the, so far in this match with that big overhand right that happened in the first. Nice leg kick there by Pacio.
Two-punch combination from Pacio. Backs off Saruta.
You can start to see the superficial damage on the lower lead leg of Pacio. It's starting to welt up there from that one kick. There's Saruta mixing things in with the takedowns. Skip the takedown. Now he's trying to pass the guard. Nice elevation there from Pacio to get back to his feet.
The crowd momentarily thought that Pacio had a choke locked onto the champion.
But I like the strategy from Saruta. Mix in the takedowns. Get Pacio thinking about that. At least start fearing it so he doesn't start to throw, like, so he doesn't get so comfortable with the stand-up.
Pacio fainting. So too, Saruta. Razor thin, this world title matchup at the moment. Angles again from Saruta, the cagey one. Pacio trying to counter. Inside leg from Saruta. Good jab, no right hand for company though. Turning back in, looking for the liver of Saruta. It's a Team Lakai specialty. The impact, the liver.
Final warning.
Very large target. Just to the right of the stomach there. The impact of Vegas nerve that can close down the entire body. They say one of the most painful ways, if not the most painful way to get knocked out, is with a liver strike. Particularly a liver punch where you're driving the knuckles up in between the ninth and tenth ribs. But the turning back into the liver will do just as well. Overhand right, the cranium cracker there from Pacio. Just need a little bit more mustard behind it. Outside leg kick. Now Pacio starting to land some heavier strikes, Dragon.
He is, he's starting to put together those kicks, with a little bit more of the punches as well. He's throwing combinations, he's getting a little more comfortable.
Turning
spinning
back
though. That time Saruta was able to step to the side of it. He's starting to see it coming. Because the problem is when he steps to the side, he's able to avoid it. But when he goes back, he tries to ride the wave of that kick to it, to kind of take away some of the pressure from it. I don't think it's hurting him so much, but it's scoring in the mind of the judges. And also the score sheets.
1:15 remains. Don't forget we are scoring an overall bout, not round by round, under these one championship global rule sets. High kick again from Pacio. Saruta leans back in evasion. Left hook from the champion.
In the third round.
Pacio again bound up and spun on Saruta. Did you expect a little bit more action from Saruta?
I did, especially in this third round. He started the first round off very effectively, and then he's kind of gotten slowed down as the matches went on. But Pacio is not really doing as much as I thought he would do either. He's landed a few beautiful side kicks, and that's really been the most significant strike of this round. I do like the takedown that Saruta hit at the beginning.
Overhand right there from Pacio. Inside leg goes Saruta. Final second to the third of five. Let's see if we have some more pepper, some more get up and go with Yosuke Saruta. Body punches here from Pacio. Saruta turns him around against the fence and drives the corky knees into the thighs. Pacio turns the champion.
Saruta placing the hand there on the knee to stop any retaliation from the knees from Pacio.
Body shot from Pacio, got in quick, got out even quicker. High kick from Saruta. Pacio. To stab himself in center circle here. Cross out the jab. Saruta does have some damage under the right eye, courtesy of that lead hand of Pacio. Some reddening on the lead thigh and shin calf area of Pacio, courtesy of the leg kicks from the champion. There's another one. Fourth round of five. Jab to Pacio. Again, Mitch gets in quick and spurs, gets out.
This is the Pacio we expected to see. We want to see those fast blitzes, bop, in and out. Saruta's kind of getting hypnotized by it. Now he's starting to come forward.
Mitch, if the match was stopped right now, who would you have ahead?
And after the first round with the knockdown, beautiful kick there from Saruta. Landed on Saruta. That big first round knockdown, but now I'm starting to see in the second, third round, Pacio starting to inch forward. I think he's more aggressive. I think his striking superiority is there.
That's a hand right counter from Pacio. After a really nice left hook from Saruta, under 3 minutes remains. Penultimate round of action here. Certainly seeing some heavier artillery being launched now by both of these world champions.
In the first match, we did not see Saruta do a kickboxing match with Joshua Pacio. He was going for takedowns. He was mixing things up. He was inside the clinch, wearing on Pacio. Now all he's doing now is he's just striking with him in the last couple rounds. But to answer your question, if the match was stopped right now, I might give a slight edge to the Team Lakai athlete.
Oh, come on!